Today I am going to discuss about one of the biggest blunder made by Einstein in his field equation of general relativity. It is too closely related to today's one of the biggest cosmological topics, dark energy and quintessence. As some of you can probably guess, it is about cosmological constant. It was first time added by Einstein, working in an equation as an extra term to describe the universe in the situation when it is static, that is, the universe is not expanding. On this concept, Albert's paradox can be explained, which argues about why we see the night sky dark even we are having infinite number of stars. I have already made a video on this. If you want to know more about this, then click on the iCard. But on 1929, Hubble gave one of his greatest law, which is also the first evidence of Big Bang, that the universe is expanding. And this made a serious problem for Einstein to work on his equations. So on 1931, he finally decided to abandon his concept. But what was the need that the Einstein had to try to use the cosmological constants? Actually, he was trying to solve the differential equation that describes space-time. Thus, Einstein needed to add a constant term to avoid having the universe collapse upon itself. This term balances the attractive force of gravity contributed by all of the matter in the universe. Physically, this term represents the vacuum energy, the possibility that the empty space possesses density and pressure, thus preventing the universe from collapsing. If the universe expands slightly, then the expansion releases vacuum energy, which causes yet more expansion. At last, Einstein corrected his equation by simply putting the value of cosmological constant as zero. But in the year 1998, it was discovered that the expansion of universe is accelerating. This implies as the possibility of positive non-zero value for the cosmological constant. So we understand that its value may positive or zero. But how can we determine it? One of the most preferential way is by using cosmic microwave background or CMB through the Planck satellite. We measure the small temperature and density fluctuations in the early universe between different locations and the subsequent changes in the radiation streaming from those locations. From fitting the CMB's power spectrum with the parameters that determine the expansion of the universe, hence physicists get a value for the cosmological constant. Another way to determine the cosmological constant is to deduce the expansion of the universe from the redshift of the light from distant sources. According to quantum field theory, this space is not empty. It is full of virtual particles which exhibit fluctuations, and it is a collection of quantum fields. One practical example of this is gravitational wave, because when these waves travel, they must require a medium like sound waves. So this indicates that there should be something in the empty space which is providing the waves as a source. These quantum fields exhibit fluctuations at their ground state called as zero point energy. If you want to know more about zero point energy, I have already made a video on this. You can check it out in the iCard. These zero-point fluctuations made a major role in cosmological constant, but theoretically when its value is found, it gives enormous rise to vacuum energy. The difference between theorized vacuum energy from quantum field theory and observed vacuum energy from cosmology is a source of major contention, with the values predicted exceeding observation by some 120 orders of magnitude, a discrepancy that has been called the worst theoretical prediction in the history of physics. This issue is called the cosmological constant problem, and it is one of the greatest unsolved mysteries in science. The cosmological constant lambda is the simplest possible explanation for dark energy and is issued in the current standard model of cosmology known as lambda CDM model. The cosmological constant also gave evidence for the existence of multiverse. It was given by a Nobel Prize winner scientist Steven Weinberg, who explained this theory with the help of anthropic principle, which deals with the fact that why human beings came into existence in this universe. As I told you, the cosmological constant is 10 to the power 120 times smaller than what it should be. So the theory of nature should have at least 10 to the power 120 different values of cosmological constant. But each universe have only one value of cosmological constant. So it proves that there are many more universes other than our universe. At last, it is the most controversial topic among the physicists. There are many ways to find its value, but none of them are agreed by any science community. The widely accepted value is zero, but we can hope some suitable theory would be given in the future which can finally explain all these doubts. So guys, that's all for today. You can check my other videos too, and please like and subscribe my channel for these kind of curious topics. At last, thank you for watching.